In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Bishop Sutton, we have come together today to welcome the Reverend Andrew Rutledge, who has been chosen to serve as rector of All Saints Parish. We believe that he is well qualified and that he has been prayerfully and lawfully selected.
Andrew, do you, in the presence of this congregation, commit yourself to this new trust and responsibility?
I do.
To the congregation, will you who witnessed this new beginning support and uphold Andrew in this ministry?
We will.
Then let us offer our prayers to God for all his people, for this congregation, and for Andrew, their rector.
God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, Holy Trinity, one God, we pray to you, Lord Christ, for the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with truth and love, and be found without fault at the day of your coming, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. All members of your church in their vocation and ministry, that they may serve you in true and godly life, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Michael, our presiding bishop, and for all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may be filled with your love, may hunger for truth, and may thirst after righteousness, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our divisions may cease, and that all may be one in you as the Father are one, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord.
For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who do not yet believe, and for those who have lost their faith, that they may receive the light of the gospel, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in positions of public trust, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the communion of your church, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints they may have rest in the place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Rejoicing in the fellowship of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God. To you, O Lord, our God.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. My friends, I had somehow skipped to read the letter of institution. I will do this at this time before we pray in the hopes that our prayers have more substance. Andrew B. Rutledge, Presbyter of the Church of God, you have been called to work together with your bishop and fellow presbyters as a pastor, priest, and teacher, and to take your place in the councils of the church. Now, in accordance with the canons, you have been selected to serve God at All Saints Parish in Sunderland. This letter is a sign that you are fully empowered and authorized to exercise this ministry as rector, accepting its privileges and responsibilities as a priest of this diocese in communion with your bishop. Having committed yourself to this work, do not forget the trust of those who have chosen you. Care alike for young and old, strong and weak, rich and poor. By your words and in your life, proclaim the gospel. Love and serve Christ's people. Nourish them and strengthen them to glorify God in this life and in the life to come. May the Lord, who has given you the will to do these things, give you the grace and power to perform them. Given under my hand and seal in the city of Baltimore on the 22nd day of May 2022, in the 14th year of my consecration. And now, Andrew, would you turn back to the first page once again? Do you, in the presence of this congregation, commit yourself to this new trust and responsibility?
Now I definitely do.
Yes. Then all is in order. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Ever-living God, strengthen and sustain Andrew, that with patience and understanding, he may love and care for your people, and grant that together they may follow Jesus Christ, offering to you their gifts and talents through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first lesson from Joshua, column 1, 7 through 9. A reading from the book of Joshua. Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the laws of my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from him into the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on a day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from St. Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 12, verses 1 through 18. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body, we have many members, and not all the members have the same function. So we who are many are one body in Christ, and individually we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in proportion to faith, ministry in ministering, the teacher in teaching, the exhorter in exhortation, the giver in generosity, the leader in diligence, the compassionate in cheerfulness. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in suffering. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints. Extend hospitality to strangers. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live peaceably with all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My friends, before the singing of the gradual hymn, do pay particular attention, listen intently to the gospel lesson that is read. It is different from the one that is in the leaflet, so you will be reading with your eyes closed.
Oh, The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
As the Lord was going to Jerusalem with his disciples, he appointed 70 others and sent them on ahead of him in pairs to every town and place where he himself intended to go. He said to them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Lord be with you.
With you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we come before you with all thanks and all praise for this wonderful day. We pray for your Holy Spirit to be here with us now. Draw us together, draw us to you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please. Well, good afternoon. What a momentous occasion, a most auspicious day. Bishop Sutton, Andrew's family, visiting clergy, and the wonderful vestry and the wonderful people of All Saints Parish, I'm so glad and thankful to be with you all today. I truly give thanks to God for this day and for the opportunity to worship God with you all this afternoon. Now, my name's Maurice Dyer, and I'm coming from the Diocese of Pennsylvania, and it's a great honor to stand before you as the preacher for this celebration of new ministry, this magnificent community of faith, to share this new day for you, blessed people of All Saints Parish and the Diocese of Maryland, and for the institution of my friend and my brother, the Reverend Andrew Rutledge, as your rector. I have to say, Andrew is a good man, a faithful man. I've known Andrew for quite a few years now. And one thing that I know without a shadow of a doubt, in the many years to come, he will fill this space with laughter, holy laughter and joy. Andrew brings with him many gifts as your rector, some of which you may have noticed already. Andrew is a gifted teacher, a profound preacher, and an excellent storyteller. To know Andrew as I do, chiefly above all other gifts, Andrew has this amazing capacity to love God and to love others. As Jesus says, people will know that you are a follower of Christ by your love. All Saints Parish, you have called for a rector, a follower of Christ. Andrew has many gifts to offer you as your rector, but as you and I know, one person does not possess all of the gifts. So I give thanks this afternoon for the opportunity to encourage you all and to call every single one of you here today and all in this community to bring your love, to bring your gifts, to bring your energy to this new phase in the life and ministry of All Saints Parish. You know, the life of a church is not so unlike each of our individual lives. highs and lows, days of great joy and celebration, days of sorrow and profound loneliness. But what I know to be true about living a life together and living a life with God is that we need purpose. So I want to ask you all a question. What is your purpose? God has a purpose for each and every one of us, each and every one of you gathered here, and for this community. Our readings reflect this truth. The Apostle Paul, in his letter, is speaking to a church not so unlike this one, a church that is forming into something new, searching for its purpose as it charts its path forward. Paul offers a most profound metaphor to describe the nature of the church. He describes the church as a body. He says, "Brothers and sisters, I appeal to you by the mercies of God to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God. Do not be conformed by this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you not to think of yourselves more highly than you ought to, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body, we have many members, and not all the members have the same function. So we who are many are one body in Christ. And individually, we are members of one another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in proportion to faith. Ministry in ministering. The teacher in teaching. The exhorter in exhortation. The giver in generosity. The leader in diligence. Compassionate in cheerfulness. All Saints Parish, I've come here today on this very, very fine day to ask you to find your purpose. It's going to take all of you, each and every one of you. Each and every one of you has gifts to offer, gifts to bring to the table. In the life of this community and in the coming together of a people and its rector, find your purpose. Calvert County, the world needs you. What is your purpose? Once a person, a body, finds its God-given purpose, well, I think Teresa of Avila said it best. Be who God meant for you to be, and you will set the world on fire. All Saints, be who God meant for you to be, and you will set the world on fire. So I think this is a true fact, that this church, it sits on the highest point in the county. Is that right? Yeah, okay, that's what I've been told. Okay, very good. Like a city on a hill, perhaps. You have a duty to let the light here shine bright for the rest of the county to see. You have a duty to be that example, so that the people know that you are followers of Christ. As Jesus says, just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciple, if you have love for one another. This is it. This is our purpose, that you know the love that God has for each and every one of us in Jesus Christ, and that you share that love with others. Let this love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal, but be ardent in spirit and serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in suffering and persevere in prayer. All saints, now is the time. Take this opportunity, and you, with all of your gifts and the laughter and love that Andrew possesses, come together and share the love of Christ in a world that so desperately needs it. And if you do, together, you will set the world on fire. Amen.
Thank you, Father Maurice. Now let us attend to the giving of the gifts of ministry.
Father Andrew, accept this Bible and be among us as one who proclaims the word.
Amen. Andrew, take this water, especially being on the highest point in this county, and help me to baptize in the name of Christ. Amen.
Andrew, receive this stole and be amongst us as pastor and priest.
Amen.
Father Andrew, receive this book of common prayer and be among us as a man of prayer.
Amen. Yes, amen.
Andrew, receive this key. Let the doors of this place be open to all.
Amen. Let me see this key. What does this open?
Kevin, they're safe. I guess it's something that's special.
Well, thank you.
Andrew, receive these musical resources and with them find music to help enrich the spiritual lives of those who worship in this community.
Amen.
Oh my word.
Books.
A lot of books.
Andrew, obey these canons and be amongst us to represent us in the councils of the diocese.
Amen. Amen.
Take this bread and wine and be among us to break the bread and bless the cup.
Amen.
Andrew, accept these gifts to represent the representation of outreach and support us in our eager support of hospitality to all.
Amen.
Help us interpret
with
all ages
in
God's good
news. Amen.
Amen.
Andrew received this gift as symbol of the merger of All Saints and the Trail of Souls with the local Black history in Southern Maryland. That history is currently on display in the form of a story map at Jefferson Patterson Park Museum. All Saints Parish and the Trail of Souls have been added to that story map, and it will rotate throughout Southern Maryland as we work to love all of our neighbors.
Amen. Amen. Andrew, let all these be signs of the ministry, which is mine and yours in this place.
O Lord my God, I am not worthy to have you come under my roof, yet you have called your servant to stand in your house and to serve at your altar. To you and to your service I devote myself, body, soul, and spirit. Fill my memory with the record of your mighty works. Enlighten my understanding with the light of your Holy Spirit. And may all the desires of my heart and will center and what you would have me do. Make me an instrument of your salvation for the people entrusted to my care, and grant that I may faithfully administer your holy sacraments, and by my life and teaching set forth your true and living word. Be always with me in carrying out the duties of my ministry. In prayer, quicken my devotion, in praises, heighten my love and gratitude. In preaching, give me readiness of thought and expression, and grant that by the clearness and brightness of your holy word, all the world may be drawn into your blessed kingdom. All this I ask for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Andrew, welcome to the Diocese of Maryland.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Let's go to
God's peace with one another.
Peace be with you. Peace, peace, peace. Peace be with you. Please, please. Please. Thank you very much. I loved it. You did Paul proud.
Cease the peace, please. Lest too much peace break out in Sunderland. Father Andrew, a word of greeting before the offering.
Well, first of all, welcome.
This is All Saints Parish, and I am your rector. If you are visiting, you are truly welcome. Housekeeping stuff, if you need some, make a bio break or adult needs, just write down at our parish hall is where the restrooms are. Just go straight to the front door, and you'll find some restrooms. That's what I always want to know when I come to a new place, first of all. But truly, thank you. Thank you so much. This is a Sunday afternoon and a hot May day, and you all have chosen to be here than anywhere else. And I just really appreciate it. And to all of you on Zoom who are joining us, hello. I could see people from Calvert County, and all the way from Calvert County to California, Austin, Texas. It means the world to me. Oh my God, and Chicago. It's really overwhelming to see the support that I have from all of you all. There is a wonderful reception. Do not leave very quickly after the service. The Episcopal church women and their men minion helpers have put on a phenomenal reception outside. Please stick around and enjoy yourself. It's just going to be right out here. And hopefully there's 40% chance of rain, but we're risking it. We're really risking it. Thank you to Maurice Dyer for a beautiful sermon. We're best friends from seminary, and glad he could be here. Welcome to my family, my mother, my brother, who's the photographer. Thank you, Alex. His wife, Amanda. My first cousin, Megan, and her husband, John, who came all the way from North Carolina. Thank you very much for being here. And thank you to the vestry. Thank you to the search calling committee. It's just humbling to be here. A lot of things had to fall into place for me to be standing right here, right now. And not the least of them was the Holy Spirit that guided me here to you. And I have no doubts that this is exactly where I'm supposed to be for a long, long time. So thank you.
Thank you. My friends, we also bring greetings from the other almost 110 parishes, missions, congregations, worshiping communities of the Episcopal Diocese of Maryland. There is so much going on, and we're a diocese on the move. Come visit us at episcopalmaryland.org sometime. And if you're not getting news about announcements, such as announcements about my future and all of that in the next phase, it means you have not subscribed. You go to that episcopalmaryland.org and click on subscribe, and you will get one email maybe twice a month. That's chock full of information. Episcopal Maryland, that's one word. If you don't know how to spell Episcopal, I don't know why you're here. Our vision as a diocese is that we're a community of love. All Saints Church has demonstrated its love for all people in so many ways. And you're a leader. This congregation is a leader in showing the love of Christ in this part of Calvert County. I was so pleased when you called Andrew, because he is also a priest who's known for his ability to extend God's love everywhere. As a community of love, we stress community. And so our custom at celebrations of new ministry is for all the clergy, your colleagues, to stand and say aloud, shout out your name, where it is you minister, and perhaps your connection, if you have one, to Andrew. We'll start with Lisa and go around and with Maurice. So stand, and you may take your mask off if you want to shout it out.
People won't hear me otherwise. Lisa Siciliano, Regional Deacon for Southern Maryland, and it is my privilege to serve here at All Saints, St. Paul's, Prince Frederick, and Christ Church West River, and anyone else I can throw a lasso around.
And the other Lisa.
I am Lisa Bortani, interim at St. Mark's in Highland, Maryland, and I know Andrew from seminary. He's one of my sacristan colleagues.
Jeff Huell, rector of All Hallows Parish, Edgewater, Davidsonville, and I know Andrew all the way back to 2012 at our very first VTS picnic. He was one of the first people I met at seminary.
VTS stands for Virginia Theological Seminary.
Yes.
My name is Christopher Garcia. I'm the rector at Christ Church Fort Republic, which is Calvert County's oldest congregation.
Oh.
And I know Andrew just as a day. Welcome. Glad to have you here.
I'm a chaplain. I'm a chaplain. I see all the school in Washington, D.C., and I know Andrew from the city.
All right. Yes, sir.
Brooke Wallen from St. Peter's, Arlington, Diocese, Virginia. I've been in the seminary here for
Okay. You. Pardon.
wonder if it would be nice if you did that. I would say, well, I would say, your fellow West Virginia, I got
that. All righty.
I'm Charles Carroll. I'm director of pastoral care at Asbury Solomons in Solomons, Maryland. Also, I'm a participant in the Catholic Interfaith Council, which is delighted to welcome you here to Catholic County. And I am the United Methodist infiltrator in this service. But it's good to have you, and I look forward to getting to know you soon.
I'm Matt Pum. I'm rector of St. Paul's in Prince Frederick, which is that way. That way. Yes, when I'm outside of the building, I'm planning. We're the youngest Episcopal church in Calvert County. Right. Like 1860 something.
Oh, I was going to say. Yes, it's been a while. It's been a minute. Yeah.
I'm Amanda Warren, and I'm a multi-vocational priest in the Diocese of Virginia, and I'm a classmate of Andrew's from seminary. Yes. Yes, I'm from Calvert County, so it's been a meal.
I'm Betsy Benoffer, and I am retired, allegedly, and I attend church here most of the time, and I love singing with the choir.
I'm Cheryl Munn. I'm a retired military chaplain with the United Church of Christ, but then moved to the Episcopal Church after retiring and settled here at All Saints. And I was on the calling committee, and we are very happy that the Lord led us to Andrew.
Thank you. And Maurice, you can still introduce yourself. Please do again.
Sure.
And just join me in gratitude for that very fine honor.
Maurice Dyer. I'm coming from Wayne, Pennsylvania, and a classmate of Andrew's. Thank you.
Thank you.
My friends, the church needs leaders. We need leaders. You've heard from some of our clergy leaders, but you know that 98% of the leaders we need, the church, are in the lay order. We need you. We need you now more than ever. Please support Andrew and his ministry here as a clergy leader. And each of you take stock and discern, how am I a leader also in my parish? We cannot do it without you. And now for the funnest part of the service, we get to give. And some translations of the offering will associated with the word hilaritas. This is a hilarious moment. This is a moment of receiving glad tidings and sharing it. And so traditionally the gifts that you give at this service goes to the discretionary account for the rector. There is one here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, there is now. and so give generously. And if you don't have a smile on your face when you're giving, then you clearly have not given enough.
All this is great, and much celebration is appropriate. But what happens next is the most important thing that we're going to be doing all day. It is the Lord's Supper, and it is for all of God's people. No matter where you are on your journey of faith, you are welcome at this table. So please walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, this is the joyful feast of the people of God, and they will come from north and south and east and west to be at the table of the Lord. Blessed are they who eat at the banquet feast of heaven. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give them thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true and paschal Lamb, who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again, he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you made known to us in creation, and the calling of Israel to be your people, and the word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life.
On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. When he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me."
After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sin. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father,
we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant.
Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ and bring us to that heavenly country where, with all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, thank you.
Let us conclude our prayer. Let us pray. Almighty Father, we thank you for feeding us with the holy food,
the body and blood of your Son, and for uniting us through him in the fellowship of your Holy Spirit. We thank you for raising up among us faithful servants in the ministry of your word and sacraments. We pray that Andrew may be to us
And a prayer for mission for All Saints Church. Let us pray. Dear God, guide us as All Saints Parish to be an inclusive and caring Christ-centered community, nurtured by our virtual tradition.
We ask you to strengthen and guide us as we live out our mission to welcome and celebrate the diversity of all people through spiritual education, growth in faith, and service in Christ's name. Amen.
Dr. Andrew, whoever you are, please greet this new congregation as their rector.
Dear friends, life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who journey the way with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind. And may God's blessing, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen.